Okay, so let's try this one. What is the pH of a 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3 molar KOH solution? So we know the concentration of KOH, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3 molar. We also know what KOH does when we put it into water, right? So we can think of KOH, we can think of it as solid, putting it into water if we want. Or you can start at aqueous, whatever. It breaks up into the K plus AQ and the hydroxide minus AQ. Okay? So, what's the concentration of potassium ions then?
1.0
times 10 to the negative 3rd. Yeah, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3rd, right? Because we went through what a lot of people like to call the mole hole, right? So, we said moles here, right? It's a 1-to-1 ratio, right? So, the moles must be the same here, okay? If it was a 2-to-1 ratio, it would be twice that amount, right? Okay. But it doesn't matter what the concentration of potassium ions are, right? It does matter what the concentration of hydroxide ions are. Why does it matter that?
To find the pOH.
Yeah, you got to find the pOH, right? What are the two molecules that affect pH again?
OH
minus, right?
H plus,
okay? Those of you who aren't responding, you guys gotta, we only got a little bit of time, you know? I want you guys to do well, okay? So, out of these three particles, which one should we care the most about the concentration if we're looking for the pH, right? The OH minus, okay? So, OH minus, it's going to be the same concentration, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3rd molar. Okay, we can figure out now from there, we can figure out the pOH if we wanted to, okay? We could also figure out the H plus concentration. We could do this a number of ways. We know KW, right? And we know, let's do it a different way. Let's do the KW. Well, we did the KWA last time, but we'll do it both ways, okay? So H3O plus times OH minus, right? What is KW again? You guys remember? Yeah, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. Okay, so do you think we could figure out the H3O plus concentration? Yeah, right? So H3O plus concentration equals KW divided by OH minus concentration. We got the OH minus concentration. We got the KW. 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14. Notice these units don't ever work, okay? So you got to just remember your units when we're doing any of this K equilibrium stuff, okay? So here, 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3. So what is it? Yeah. 1.0 times 10 to the negative 11 molar, right? So, is that the answer that we're looking for?
No,
because we're looking for the pH, right? That's the concentration of hydrogen in that. How do we do the pH? pH equals what?
Negative
log of that number, right? So what's the pH, guys? Could we have done this a different way? We could have done it the way that it wants us to do it up there, right? Yeah. Let's do it that way instead. Can I erase all that stuff? And remember, I recorded this. Okay, so. Let's do it the way we just learned, or we just got lectured on how to do it. So, instead of finding the pH, we could find the POH, which is very similar to finding the pH. POH equals what? Good job. Negative log of the OH minus concentration. Okay? So, do we know the OH minus concentration?
Yes.
Yeah? So, it's going to be the negative log of 1.0 times 10 to the negative 3. Don't worry about putting that molar in because it'll mess up your thinking. Okay, so what is that answer?
3.00.
That's the POH, right? POH equals 3.00. We also know something else. What other formula do we know? That the pKa/W equals the pH plus the POH. Isn't that right? We know that. We also know that pKa/W, is what? 14.00, right? We'll do it the same number of necessary foods. So, we should be able to figure out what the pH is doing this way, right? So, pH is going to be the pKa/W minus the pOH. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. And then that's 14.00 minus, what is it, 3.00. What do we get? 11.00. Okay? So we can do it. We can do it a number of different ways. Okay? Is everybody cool with that? So the thing you got to remember to start off with is this, right? If you don't know the chemical equation, then you can't do any of this stuff. Okay. So, any questions on this? Pretty straightforward, right?